Okay, students, good morning. Today we are going to start with the next topic of real numbers, that is fundamental theorem of arithmetic. So, what is the fundamental theorem of arithmetic? Let's see about the statement. Okay, so statement is that every composite number can be expressed as a product of primes and the factorization is unique. Means all the composite numbers are as a unique factorization, unique prime factorization, unique prime factorization. This is known as fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Okay. So you know what is composite number? Composite numbers. Just a quick revision from your junior classes. Composite numbers are those numbers which are not prime numbers. First of all, so not prime numbers. Secondly, which come in the table of any other number. Or third, which have more than two factors, that is other than one and itself. They are called composite numbers. Just a quick revision. Okay, so like for example, with the help of example I will explain this. Like for example, if we are having a number, let's say 54. So 54 is a composite number because it can be divided by 2, it can be divided by 9 also. Okay, so it can be divided by 3 also. It is having factors other than 1 and itself. It is having more than 2 factors. So if we want to express it in the form of prime factorization, we can express it as product of primes. So how will it express? By prime factorization. 54, 2's are 4, remainder is 1, 2 7's are 14, 3 9's are 27, 3 3's are 9, 3 1's are 3. So 54 can be written as 2 raised to the power 1 into 3 raised to the power 3. So it is said that in this factorization, unique apart from the order in which, means order can be reversed. Like you can also write it as 3 power 3 into 2 power 1. But this is not the different prime factorization. This is the same prime factorization. Only difference is that the order is reversed. So it is saying that every composite number has a unique prime factorization apart from the order. Order may be different. Okay, someone can write factorize 3 first and 2 afterwards. But standard form it is there only that the smallest prime, we will start with the smallest prime number and then we will move to the next prime number. Okay, and one more thing is very important. All the factors must be prime numbers, then only it is called the prime factorization. If we are having the factors other than prime numbers, then they are this is factorization, but this is not a prime factorization. For a prime factorization, all the factors must be prime. So this is what we call as prime factorization. Very simple theorem that any composite number can be expressed as the product of prime and the factorization is unique apart from the order in which the prime factors are occurring. Okay, now look at this question. In this question it is said that we are having any number 4. Consider a number 4 where n is any natural number, and n is any natural number. We have to check whether the value of, for any value of n, the 4 power n ends with digit 0. So the value of n can be any natural number. Natural number start with 1. So 1, 2, 3, dot. And we have to see that for any value of n, 4 raised to the power n, for any value of n, it is ending with 0 or not. Means, for example, if we say that the value of n is 1, then it 4 power 1, it is 4. So the digit is not ending with 0. 4 power 2, it is 16, it is also not ending with 0. So we have to check for any value of n, the whether the digit, ending digit will be 0. We have to check whether for any value of n, this end digit is 0 or not. So this will be, so let me tell you one thing, like in any number, in order to get number 1 as 1, to get end digit 0, to get end digit 0, it must have at least one pair of 2 and 5 as the factor, or 2 into 5 as prime factor. Okay, 2 into 5 as prime factor. Like, for example, if we are looking at this, so if I am saying 4 raised to the power n, okay, so 4 raised to the power n, we can write it as 4 is the square of 2, so we can write 2 raised to the power 2 whole raised to the power n. So a raised to power m into n, law of exponents, it can be written as 2 raised to the power 2n. So you can clearly see that it is having 2 as the only prime factor. It is having 2 is the only prime factor. It is not having 5 as the factor. Okay, we do not have 5 as the factor. 2 is the only prime factor. Only prime factor. 5 is not the factor of 4 power n. Therefore, we can say that, therefore, for any value of n, 4 raised to the power n will not end with digit 0. Are you getting my point? Okay, I have told you just for any number to get one end digit 0, it must have at least one pair of 2 and 5 as the prime factor. But it is not having any digit, so it is having only 2 as the prime factor, so 4 raised to power n will not end up with digit 0. Similarly, we can take some other examples also. Let's take, say, 5 power n. So 5 power n or 6 power n. So it is also cannot have, it has only 5 as the only factor. ठीक है? So 2 is not the factor. So it will not end with digit 0. With digit 0. Similarly here, 2 into 3 raised to the power n. So it will have either 2 as the prime factor and 3 as the prime factor. But 5 is not the prime factor. So it should have at least 2 and 5 both. as one of the one factor should be 2 and one factor should be 5 at least, so that it will end with 0. It will not end with digit 0. Okay, hope it is clear. Similarly, if suppose we are having 10 raised to the power n, so 10 raised to the power n, it will have 2 as one of the factor and 5 as one of the factor. So it will end with digit 0. Because it is both having 2 as well as 5. Like for example, if I say 10 raised to the power 1, so is equal to 10, 0 is the end digit, end digit is 0. Okay, and if I am saying 10 raised to the power 2, so 10 raised to power 2 can be written as 2 into 5 raised to the power 2, means we are having two pairs of 2 and 5 as the prime factor. So if we are having two pairs of 2 and 5, then it will be having two digits at the end, end digits will be 0. And if we are having 10 raised to power 3, that is 2 into 5 raised to power 3, that is 2 raised to power 3 into 5 raised to power 3, that is we are having last 3 end digits will be 0. So two pairs of 2 and 5, so it will have two end digits zero. And if we are having three pairs of 2 and 5, so it will have three end digits. So three pair of 2 and 5 is there, then three end digits will be 0. Okay, like here in 10 you have one end digit 0, it is having one pair of 2 and 5 as prime factor. In 100 we are having two end digit 0, here we are having two pairs of 2 and 5 as factors, prime factors. And here 1000 we are having three end digit 0, we are having three pairs of 2 and 5 as prime factors. So like this it will continue. Now we are having one more example, easy one, we have already done in junior classes. Find LCM and HCF by the prime factorization method. So if we do the prime factorization of 6, starting with 2, so 6 we are having the prime factors as 2 into 3, can be expressed as product of primes as 2 into 3. And the second one is 20, so 20, 2 tens are 20, then followed by 3, 10 is not divisible by 3, so 5, 5 twos are 10, it should be 2 first. So it should be 2 first, it should be 2, 5's are 10 and then 5 ones are 5. So 20 we are having prime factors as 2. So the prime factorization of 20 will be 2 into 2 into 3. So, or we can write 6 as, so here we can say that highest common factor is 2 is the HCF, 2 is the highest common factor. And LCM of 6 and 20 will be 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 5. Sorry, it will be 5, not 3, multiplied by 5. Or we can say like this, ki HCF, and, for example, 6 can be written as 2 into 3 and 20 can be written as 2 raised to the power 2 into 5. HCF, highest common factor, is the HCF is what? HCF is the highest power, the common factor with lowest power, with its lowest power. This is the HCF. So 2 is the common factor, and here the power is 1, here the power is 2, So SCF will be 2 only, okay, that is equal to 2. Now LCM is the product of common factors with highest powers and uncommon factors. Like here, 2 is the common factor. 2 is the common factor. So highest power of 2 is 2. So LCM will be 2 raised to the power 2 multiplied by the uncommon factor, that is 3 and 5 into 3 into 5. Okay, understood? Now, so this is how we can calculate the LCM and SCF for the any two positive integers. Now, next thing is that one more thing, this is also the result which you have done from your previous class, junior classes, for any two positive integers or any two positive or any two positive integers a and b are the two positive integers, then the product of integers will be equal to the, like, product of integers is small a times of small b, will be equal to SCF of the integer, that is SCF of a and b multiplied by the LCM of a and b. Okay, this is the formula. This you have studied in your junior classes, the same formula. Like here in the above case, the product of integers, the value of a is 6 and 20. So 6 into 20 will be equal to SCF of 6 and 20 is 2 multiplied by LCM. That is LCM we have not calculated. LCM will be 2 to the 4, 4 to the 12, 12 5 is 60. So 60 into 2 is 120, and 6 into 2, 20 is also 120. Okay, understood? Or from this only other formulas can be derived that SCF will be equal to product of integers upon LCM, and similarly LCM is equal to product of integers upon SCF. Okay, the same formula basically, that product of integers is equal to the product of their LCM and SCF. Okay, let's do some example based on it. Find the SCF and LCM. SCF of 96 and 404 by prime factorization method, and find their LCM. Okay, so SCF for 96, first we will take out the factors of 96. 2 4s are 8, 2 8s are 16, 2 2s are 4, 2 4s are 8, 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 2 6s are 12, 2 3s are 6, and 3 1s are 3. So we can write 96 as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2 raised to the power 5 multiplied by 3. And second is 404. Again 2 to the 4, 0, 2 to the 4, then 2 1 the 2, 0, 2 1 the 2. Again 1, 0, 1 is prime, so we will not have any other factor. So 404 can be written as 2 raised to the power 2 into 1 over 1. So highest common factor, which is the SCF, highest common factor of 96 and 404 will be equal to the product of the product of the common will be equal to the common factors, product of common factor. Here we are having only one common factor with their lowest power. HCF we have lowest power, LCM we have highest power. So lowest power is 2. So 2 raised to power 2, that is HCF will be equal to 4. Okay. Now LCM will be by find their LCM. So LCM is equal to product of numbers upon HCF. So product of numbers 96 into 404 upon HCF, that is 4. So again we can solve it. 4 1 the 4 0 4 1 the 4 96 into 101. So 96 into 101, simple, 6 1 the 6 0 6 1 6 9 1 9 0 9 1 9 6 9 6 9 6 9 6. So we have got the LCM as 9696. Okay, understood. Now next question is, you have to find the LCM of 120 using prime factorization. Simply, like we have done in the previous question, 2 3 the 6 3 1 the 3, 72 prime factors will be 2 3 the 6 2 6 the 12, 2 1 the 2 2 8 the 16, 2 9 the 18, 3 3 the 9, 3 1 the 3. 120 prime factorization will be 2 6 the 12, 2 3 the 6, 2 15 the 30, then 3 5 the 15, and 5 1 the 5. So the prime factors of 2 will 6 will be 2 into 3. Prime factor of 72 will be 2 raised to the power 3 into 3 raised to the power 2. Then 120, it is equal to 2 raised to the power 3 into 3 into 5. Again HCF is the product of the common factors with their lowest power. So 2 is the common factor, 2 raised to power 3, 2 raised to power 3, 2 raised to power 1. So lowest power is 2 raised to power 1 into 3 is again the common factor, 3 raised to power 1, 3 raised to power 2, 3 raised to power 1. So 3 is the common factor. So the HCF is equal to 6. Okay. Now LCM. LCM is the product of their common factor with their highest power. So 2 raised to power 3, 2 raised to power 3. Highest power of the common factor 2 is 2 raised to power 3. Then again 3. 3 is the common factor, and highest power 3 is 3 raised to 1, 3 raised to power 2, 3 raised to power 1, 3 raised to power 2. Multiplied by the product of non-common factors. So apart from 2 and 3, 5 is only the non-common factors. 2 to the 4 to the 8, into 3 to the 9, into 5, 9 to the 45, 45 into 8. So we get 8 5 is 40, 4 carry, 8 4 is 32 plus 4 36, 360. So LCM is 360. Okay. So this is how we will calculate the LCM and HCF. Here we will not apply the formula product of the two numbers is equal to LCM into HCF. Okay. Here the product of the numbers will not be equal to the product of HCF and LCM, because here we are not having two numbers, here we are having three numbers. We are having the formula for this also, but that is not in your course. Okay, but for the sake of your knowledge I will tell you the formula is LCM for the numbers say A, B and C will be equal to the product of numbers A, B and C into the HCF of A, B and C upon HCF of A into B, A and B into HCF of B into C into HCF of A and C. Okay, this is the formula. Although this is not in course, not in syllabus, but for the sake of your knowledge, for those students who want to have, who want to know little bit extra, okay, for those I'm telling this. Although you don't have to worry about it, it is not in syllabus. Similarly, if you want to find out the HCF, so HCF of A, B and C, now you can predict the product of the three numbers multiplied by the LCM of the three numbers A, B and C upon the LCM of AB into LCM of BC into LCM of AC. Okay. So with this we have completed the topic. Now we can start the exercise 1.2 in the next class.